Hi, I'm Jeff Bradshaw of Redneck Restorations. This old truck brought to you by ElderlyIron.com and OldFarmAuction.com, Internet's only auction sites dedicated to old cars, trucks, tractors, and related parts. On the way, we're going to tell you the story that everybody dreams of. It's called The Find. Well, by now you're probably wondering, well, what does this old thing have to do with a find? It doesn't look like much of a find. It's a 76 GMC 3/4 ton, two-wheel drive. Almost a shell by now. Well, about a year ago, I traded this truck for a hood, for a 71 Chevy. I got the truck, they got the hood. I never did go pick it up until I found somebody that needed a door, and this one happened to have a driver's door, so I went ahead and drug it home. Well, I went to rifling through the interior. Just all kinds of stuff in here. I don't want to throw it on the ground because I don't feel like picking it back up again. Things loaded with trash. Amongst the trash, I found this piece of paper. Now I'm thinking to myself, oh good, here's the title for the truck. So when I go to scrap this thing, I don't have to worry about it. Here's the title, the way it goes. But when I look at it closely, like this, you see it, 1956 GMC stake bed. Well, Jeff's favorite truck is a 1956 GMC, and he don't really care whether it's a stake bed or not, because I've got a 91 GMC sitting down in the pasture. It's been rolled, so it's got a 95,000 mile four-wheel drive drivetrain on it with a fuel injected 350. Anyway, I look up the name in the phone book that happens to be on the title, and it doesn't exist. So I go out on the road and try to find the address out there, and it doesn't exist. So I get on the internet and I type in the address of it, and sure enough, something pops up. So I call the people up, and they don't have any idea who this person is until I tell them, well, I found this title to a 56 GMC truck. Oh, you mean that guy? Yeah, he's still around. Truck's still here too. Well, I gotta talk to this guy. So I call him up and we make an arrangement. I come out and look at the truck, make him an offer, and he accepts it. And this is the rest of the story. Now at 8.2 miles, this is where we leave the pavement. Almost to the California border, the fringes of the wilderness in southern Oregon. And there it is, the find. 1956 GMC. 2.5 ton truck. Factory V8, automatic, power steering. Deluxe interior, chrome package, and four-wheel drive. Well, here is the find. Might not look like much right away. But it's quite the truck, quite a rare beast. And it's all still intact. It'll take a little while to get her roadworthy, but well worth the effort. That tire looks like it's not going to survive getting air to it. Good thing I brought a couple more. Got a box full of junk. It's all got to go. Get busy. so we can tow it here. I think the floor's rotten. Much saving it anyway. All gotta be rebuilt. Now with that load off of there, I'll see if the tires came up any. No. Well, on this truck, it looks like I've got one tire that might hold air. And that would be this inboard tire right here. Now, when you have a dual rim type truck, there's these things here called handholds. Well, that's what everybody calls them. The technical term, I don't really know. But the idea is when you put this tire on here, that you set the handhold to where you can access the valve stem on the inside to put air on the inboard tire. Well, whoever put the tires on this last decided to put that valve stem right about there. So now it's going to take a little extra work to get to that one. Let's see if it'll take some air. When you got 20-year-old tires on a truck, they're flat, you start putting some pressure to them, there's always a chance they can blow up on you. What's going on here? There they go. Front tires are cracked clear through the cords. Same way with the outboard tire on the other side here, and then the inboard tire's off the bead. I didn't bring any starting fluid. Probably should have. Kind of tough to do it to the inboard tires though. It's working. That's 40 pounds. I'm gonna leave it right there. That'll make him roll. We have 40 pounds of air in the tank. Two more tanks. And three more tires. I imagine it's a little bit dangerous. But it's holding. Sure saved me a lot of work. That's the end of that tank. Tank number two. Stand clear. Him and his valves. There it goes. It's working! That's enough. Yes. A little more? No. Don't chance it. Just be happy and go with it. Let's try the other side. It's just gotta go on the trailer. One more tank. Got my big tank. Got an air truck. Air truck. I think we'll leave that there. Inboard's off the bead on both sides. This is only off the bead here. Alright, well let's try something. Get some wedges and stick in between those tires. Try to push that up against the bead, see if it'll take some air. Hang on to it. Now, if you remember seeing old Yeller on Redneck Restorations, this old truck, I brought along the wheels for old Yeller. Same 19.5s. Aired them up, brought them out. We need four to get her out of the hole. Get him out of the hole. Ruh-roh! Sounds like someone's coming. Well, now there's another issue. He stuck the block under the axle. That sunk down into the ground about 6 to 8 inches. Which means I can't get the jack under the axle at any location. So I'm going to have to put it on the frame. So I'm going to need a couple blocks, something to put the jack on. Jack it up, block it, let it down, re-block the jack, jack it back up again so I can take care of suspension travel. Get this thing up high enough to put a tire on here that's actually holding air. Still working. Maybe. Might be able to get that tire on there. Yes. I stick a half inch of spacers on there. That's a half inch of threading I don't have to do. Now while we got it up in here, be a good time to stick something in that hole, fill it up. You're gonna get a little higher. We'll not do that a second time. Let's do the front, shall we?
Well, after taking a second look, both the front tires are sitting on a concrete pad. So we'll just clear out the junk from underneath it.
Well, that pretty much does it for getting this thing ready to pull out of here, except I can't do it by myself.
Out of the hole, heading for the trailer.
Bound down, ready to go. Time to hit the road. We'll be right back. Jimmy flew us home. Take you on a tour. Been setting for 20 years.
When I called the guy on the phone when we were talking about it, he told me it was an automatic. Well, I knew right then it had the V8. Now, you could get an 8 with a stick, but you couldn't get an automatic with a 6. He's pulled the intake manifold off of it some 15 years ago, took all the spark plugs out of it. So that engine's pretty much got to come all the way down. It's got power steering, power brakes, nice little accessorized screen in front of the radiator, accessory horn, and there's the drive unit for the tach. If I can get my camera going where it's supposed to be. I'll leave the hood up. It had undercoating everywhere. It was falling off the hood. I tore most of it off. The West Coast mirrors. The door's kind of swung around, met the fender once, so it's all tweaked out. It has the deluxe interior with the padded armrest and a two-tone color, well, three-tone color if you consider the dash, dark top side of the dash. It's got your turn signals, your automatic shifter again. It's got a tach. It's got a clock. And an add-on speedometer. Now that switch I found kind of interesting. Looked like a power window switch. Later on I found out what it was, and we'll get there. And there's our lever for the four-wheel drive. Little accessorized fire extinguisher. Brass one over there from the 50s. Has these compartments on both sides and the step wells. This one had a bunch of tire chains in it. One thing I did like is he pulled the filler neck out of there for whatever reason, I don't know. But that was good because my gas tank didn't fill up with water. However, since there was no back window in it, it kind of rained into it for 20 years. Floor's nice and rusty and seat's nice and shot. Oh, that's a charge indicator because they had a spare battery. And that's a second charge indicator that I can't focus on. It's got your radio. Where'd you go? There it is. Heater control. Well, it's got to have a heater control. Let's go to the other side. Now, that power window switch, once I got looking around, was for this power antenna. Whoever did this truck really knew what they wanted, and they accessorized this thing to the hilt. That was for the mud flaps that they used to have mounted underneath there. And of course, the four-wheel drive. Good, straight, solid door. There's no rust on the cab corner on the other side. And there's that other compartment. And of course, our spotlight with mirror. So not only is this 56 GMC Jeff's favorite truck, but it's also blue, which is Jeff's favorite color. And this color blue here, my first car was a 57 Chevy. We won't get into that story. But the interior of this matches the color of the dash of my old 57 Chevy. And the exterior matches the exterior of my old 57 Chevy. I think this was meant to be Jeff's truck. There it is. And we've been doing a restoration on Whitey, which we're following through. I know that I said in the beginning that it's going to be a redneck restoration. That turned out to be kind of like frame-up restoration. This is going to be the genuine redneck restoration. We're going to follow this one from beginning to end. From this old, stiffened up, rusty, been sitting for 20 years, to a road-ready, ready-to-work truck. Jeff's truck. For redneck restorations, this old truck. I'm Jeff Bradshaw. This is the Illinois River. I'm going to go down this bank and set up my camera for a bridge shot. There's our camera precariously perched on an outcropping of rock next to the river. And we'll roll camera. Here we go. Back up the hill.
Okay, when you come back, come down the hill and stop. Rev your motor, count to 10, in case my camera shuts down. You're trying to get it reactivated.
Oh, okay. Rev her up, count to 10. Got you. We're there. Restorations. This old truck brought to you by Elder. That didn't make much noise, did it? I need a noisier place that won't hurt. Oh.